Yes, guys, question number 35. XIX India are two companies on 31st March 2012. Summarized balance sheet as are as under. Two companies, guys, these are. Division wise balance sheets are not available for us. We need to prepare that. XIX has two divisions, very profitable A and loss making B. Yeah, similarly has two divisions, very profitable B and loss making division A. Two companies decided to reorganize. Necessary approval from the creditors and the members have been sanctioned by the court when obtained for the following scheme. Division B of XIX, that was the loss making division of B in XIX, will be transferred. It has a cost of, where fixed assets having a cost of 400 with a written down value of 160, current assets of 900 and current liabilities of 750 with the loan funds of 200 got transferred at 125 crores to YA. Division A of YA, having fixed assets costing 500 crores with a depreciation of 200 crores and your current assets of 800 crores and current liabilities of 700 crores and loan funds of 250 crores was transferred at 140 crores to XIX. The difference in the two consideration will be treated as a loan carrying interest at the rate of 15%. The directors of each company revalued the fixed assets taken over as follows. Division A of YA was taken over at 325 crores. Division B of XIX is taken over at 200 crores. These are the revalued figures of fixed assets. All other assets and liabilities to be recorded at their balance sheet values. The directors of both the companies ask you to prepare the balance sheet after the reconstruction, showing the corresponding figures before reconstruction as well. Master Ritchie, who owns 50,000 equity shares of XIX and 30,000 equity shares of YA, wants to know whether he has gained or lost in terms of net asset value of equity shares on the above reorganization. So straightforward balance sheet is what he asked. So we can't get the balance sheet so easily. What we'll try to prepare first is division wise balance sheet. I have XIX and YA. Each one has two divisions each. So what you try to prepare is XIX A and B division. Yeah, D, A and B division. Let's try to split the net assets. Oh, this is division wise net assets. Entering this column, XIX Limited and YA Limited. Under XIX, I have A and B, two divisions. YA also, I have two divisions, A and B. Okay, let's maintain even total column as well. So, A, B and total. YA also, A, B and total. Go on. Start with your assets because I'm talking about net assets. The first as of such asset is fixed assets. Cost minus depreciation is giving me a written down values. Come on, man. Place the figures. First, I'll place the total columns. Ansha, 1000 cost. Depreciation is 400. Net book value of fixed assets is 600. Ya, 700. Reduce 300 depreciation. 400 net book value. Now you can place the figures, read that point number B. First one, division B of XIX has fixed assets costing 400. This is 400. Whose written down value is 160. That means depreciation is 240. Place the other figures. 600 and 160. This will be 640. No, 440. Read the point number 2. Fixed assets, division A of YA has 500 fixed assets cost with a depreciation of 200, net book value will be 300. So fill up the balance 200 and 100. Balance is 100. There's the value of fixed assets. Pick up current assets. First fill up the total columns. Total current assets are 2000 and 1500. Fill it up. Read. Point number one. Current assets 900 is division B of CHA. This is 900. So obviously this will be 1100. Division A of CHA, current assets are 800. Division B should be 700. That is it for the total assets. Outside liabilities. Go on. First one, I'll see current liabilities first. Place the total first. Total is 1300 and 900. Place the values. Division B of CHA has current liabilities of 750. So division A should have 550. Division A of YA has a current liabilities of 700. So division B has 200. Come to loan funds. Loan funds totals are 250 and 350. Place the values. Remaining figures are all equity, guys. I don't have to consider those. Come on. Loan funds. Division B of CHA. First point, 200 crores. So division A will have 50. Division A of YA has a loan funds of 250. Or division B will have loan funds of 100. That will bring us to the end of the current net assets. That's it. 1550. This is 950. This is 300. This is 1250. This is outside liabilities. Net assets. $940, $110, $1050, $500, $650. And we have arrived at the net asset figures. How many transactions are there now? I'll call it as a set of two transactions. One transaction given in point number one, where B of CHA, this gets transferred to YA. Second transaction, division A of YA, this one, gets transferred to CHA. This is something which is happening now. So, two transactions. Whenever I have two transaction things, split the transaction into two parts. Now think about each transaction separately. When division B of CHA moves to YA Limited, I'll have two things to identify. One, what is the profit on sale to CHA? Two, what is the goodwill or capital reserve on acquisition for YA? Both I have to consider. In a similar way, when I'm talking about this transaction, what is the profit or loss on sale of division A to YA? And what is the goodwill or capital reserve for the acquisition of A from YA in the books of CHA? So I'll have to calculate both. So what we'll try to do, first try to calculate for the selling company. profit or loss. I'll write it here. This is sufficient actually. Profit or loss on sale of divisions. Let me take up two columns now. Division B of XIA is sold along with division A of YA. How do you calculate profit or loss on sale? Net assets of the division sold compared with the purchase consideration. Come on. Net assets 110 and 150. Purchase consideration for B of XIA. B of XIA is transferred at 125 crores to YA. And this one transferred at 140 crores to YA. I got more 15 rupees profit. I got less 10 rupees loss. It is not a normal transaction, it is a capital transaction. So capital profits are capital reserves. And negative capital reserve is always goodwill. Similar way, goodwill or capital reserve on acquisition. Acquisition for XIA and acquisition for YA. What did XIA acquire? XIA is the first company which acquired division A of YA. So whenever you have to calculate goodwill or capital reserve, we need to check for net assets taken over. To be compared with the amount of PC. XIA took over division A of YA. So my net assets at book values, taking everything at book values, what is the division A of YA? Net assets are 150. YA purchased division B of XIA whose net assets are 110. But on acquisition, we need to see takeover values. For purpose of takeover, there is some fixed revaluation which is talking about. Check point number 4. Directors of each company revalued the fixed assets taken over as follows. Division A of YA, who took over? XIA. Plus revaluation, plus or minus, could be anything. Revaluation of fixed assets. Look at the book value and see the revaluation. Come on. Division A of YA is taken over at 325. XIA took over. Division A of YA, what was the fixed assets value? 300. How much did he take over for? 325. 25 rupees add. Division B of XIA taken over by YA at 200. Fixed assets are 160 book value. Taken over at 200, revaluation is 40. My net asset taken over as 175 and 150. For this he pays a PC. How much PC is being paid? XIA is paying how much? XIA is paying for division A of YA 140. YA is paying for division B of XIA 125. I think capitalism in both cases. Yes, it is. 35-25. Information sufficient for you to draft the balance sheet. Sufficient enough information we gathered, guys. What is it talking about? The director of both the companies asked you to prepare the balance sheet after reconstruction, showing the corresponding figures before reconstruction. So when you prepare the balance sheet, 31st March, balance sheet as on 31st March 2012, prepare something like this. My amount column for Ksha, amount column for Ya. Again two columns. Before demerger, after demerger. Start. Shall I fill up the before demerger column first? I just copy paste, huh? Equity and liabilities. Alright, let's do it correspondingly. Share capital. Chalo. Before, Ksha has how much share capital? 300. Authorized is 500, issued is 300, yeah, before is 200. Guys, is there any purchase consideration settled in equity shares? Nothing. So this will be same. There's no issue of shares, there's no buyback, nothing given. Or take the same figures. I'll come to reserves and surplus now. Nothing will change except capital reserves. First reserve is a capital reserve. Let me write the before values first. Before acquisition it was 40 and 20. After values. Ksha. Capital reserve of 15 plus 35. 50. 50 to be added to 40. 90. This goodwill can be cancelled against the capital reserve. So, minus 10, plus 25, plus 15, plus 15, plus 20, 35. That's it. Next one is revenue reserve. Copy paste, same values, there's no change. Surplus, no change. 10, 10, 5, 5. That's it. Next come to loan funds. That is non-current liabilities. Loan funds, check your net asset statement. Come on. Ksha. Okay, before figure I can fill it up directly. Before figures are 250 and 350. After, add A plus A, add B plus B. A plus A, add loan funds A plus A is 50 plus 250, 300. B plus B, 200 plus 100, 300. Do not forget an additional liability, 15%. Third point, the difference of two considerations will be treated as a loan carrying an interest at the rate of 15%. 15% loan, no befores at all, only after. Who has to pay whom? Think and tell who has to pay whom. The consideration which Ya has to pay for taking over division B of Ksha is 125. The consideration that Ksha has to pay Ya is 140 for taking over division A. So ultimately net consideration should be paid by Ksha. So for Ksha it should be a liability. For Ya it will be an asset. For the difference in the PC, 140 minus 125, only to the extent of 15. Current liabilities. Before figures, happily pick up and figure 1300 and 900. Again, A plus A plus B plus B. Come on. A plus A. Current liabilities are 500 plus 700, 1250. B plus B, 750 plus 200, 950. That is it for this part. Liabilities total. Assets, non-current assets, tangible fixed assets. Before figures are 600 and 400. After figures, A plus A, no. Takeover values are not book values. Your takeover values, there is an increase in the valuation. So, yes, division A of Y is taken over at 325. So, not 300, 300 being the book value. Revalued to 325. So A plus A, 440 plus 325, 765. B plus B, Yas B, current assets, sorry, fixed assets are 100, but Ksha's B, assets are taken over at 200, this will become 300 then. Next. There is no goodwill, nothing. There is a 15% loan, or you write it as 15% advance now. Loan is a liability, advance is an asset. After for ya. Current assets before 2000, before for ya 1500. A plus A, 1100 plus 800, 19. B plus B, 900 plus 700, 2600, 2665, 1900, 1915. We're not done with the question answer, guys. Read. Yeah, we are done with the balance sheet, absolutely. But read the second part. Master Ritchie, who owns 50,000 shares of Cha, 30,000 shares of Ya, wants to know whether he gained or lost in terms of the net asset value of the equity shares from the above arrangement. He wants to know whether he gained or lost from this. We can calculate easily. Get the net asset values before or after. Compare both, you'll get the answer. Come on. Gain or loss to some fellow Rich. Net assets available to equity shareholders or net assets attributable to equity shareholders. Don't write everything again, man. Don't waste time. Either you can say assets minus outside liabilities or I can say share capital plus reserve. Both will be same only, no? Can you give me share capital plus reserve? Easier answer. 300 plus 40 plus 700 plus 10. Before is 1050. After is 1100. Yeah, before is 650. After is 665. Divided by the number of equity shares. What are the number of equity shares? Each share is 10 rupees. So 300 paid up share capital. So 30 and 20. 30, 20. This is 35, 35, 30, this is 36.67, this is 32.5, this is 33.25. Observe this, you will get gain or loss. In both the cases I have gain. Gain per share. This is intrinsic value per share. So identifying gain per share 1.67 in the case of Ksha. 0.75 per share in the case of Ya. Multiply with number of shares held. Ritchie holds how many shares? Ritchie holds 50,000 shares of Cha and 30,000 shares of Ya. 50,000 and 30,000. Is total gain?
$83,353, $22,750, $22,785, $83,500.
1,06,000. Yes, guys, let's take a brief look at buyback. Small portion of your law, if you can pick up something which you remember when you read about buyback, earlier section 77A as per Companies Act 1956. So basically when we are talking about buyback, the first thing, there were some conditions for buyback. First thing is, it should be authorized by articles. Okay, if it is not authorized by articles also, I can change the articles by special resolution in the AGM. Yeah, and then all the shares should be fully paid up. Then three quantified conditions which are really, really important. Three quantified conditions that we have to identify what is the maximum buyback. What we say is, the first condition, maximum buyback is only 25% of paid up share capital. I can't buy back more than this. My money applied on buyback it should be less than or equal to 25% of paid up capital plus free reserves. Well, my third condition, debt equity ratio should be at least, keep it at 2:1, not increasing more than that. If you keep buying back, your equity keeps on reducing. If your equity keeps on increasing, your debt equity ratio keeps on increasing. Not possible, guys. I have to at least maintain 2:1. Less than 2:1 is even more better. These are three quantified conditions. Other than this, we have a condition saying that they should be physically destroyed. That was long back provision, man. If there is no physical share to be destroyed or something, as far as now, we have everything in dematerialized format with the NSDL. And one more thing was, you are not supposed to issue the same class of shares within a span of 1 year. The entire buyback should be completed within a span of 1 year from the date of the resolution has been passed when you are doing the AGM. If it is a listed company, then you have to again submit with the SEBI and take an approval for it. Blah, 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 whatever it is, that is a law, things that we have to consider. Now, what we are more concerned about is, let's see the basic framework of how the accounting goes on. Now, when we're talking about the accounting for buyback, a simple way of putting it is, basically I have three entries, that's it. First one, where I buy back shares. My first transaction, when the company buys back shares. To buy back, the company has to shell out some cash. So I'll call it as buyback of shares account debit. To bank. The shares bought back cannot be reissued. There's not forfeited share. Forfeited shares, surrendered shares can be reissued. These are shares bought back. They're not similar shares. So we have to cancel these shares. Cancellation of shares bought back. Come on. How do we cancel? When I buy back shares and I cancel it, my equity share capital will reduce to the extent only of face value. Any excess you paid more than face value to acquire the share for buyback of share, we'll call it as premium on buyback. Premium on buyback account debit to buyback of shares. This premium on buyback should be cancelled. To cancel a debit, we have to credit it. Then what should be debited? Either you cancel against securities premium, either use securities premium. Sometimes if the securities premium is not available, then we can use free reserves. Premium on buyback. Now once this is done, final transaction comes up here. Whenever there's a reduction in share capital, reduction in share capital need not be, you know, attributed to only buyback of equity shares. Reduction in share capital include both equity as well as preference. Sometimes even the preference shares can redeem because you cannot issue a irredeemable preference share. The maximum duration of a preference share right now is 20 years. So when I'm redeeming a preference share, even then the share capital reduces. Whenever there's a reduction in the share capital, such reduction in the share capital should be indicated to the user. How will you indicate it to the user? I can't write statement saying that my share capital has been reduced. Not this way. So in accounting, what we do is, we'll try to create one more additional reserve, which is called a CRR. Capital Redemption Reserve. Now, this is the significance. The significance of this reserve is it shows the financial strength of a company. If I have a higher CRR, it means I accumulated so much reserve sufficient enough to even redeem my capital or buy back my shares. If I redeem the preference share capital out of fresh issue of equity shares, then CRR won't be created because CRR is what? Reduction in share capital. When preference shares are redeemed and equity shares are issued, one share capital, equity share capital increase, preference share capital decrease, both get nullified. In such situation, I cannot create CRR. Basically, I am not portraying the financial strength of the company. But here, whenever I create CRR, that means that the capital has been reduced using the reserves of the company. That means out of the profits earned by the company. So, create a CRR always. Use any free reserve. General reserve, P&L, dividend equalization fund, all unique names you'll find to free reserves only. And credit it to CRR, capital redemption reserve. That's it, only three entries to close buyback. Start reading the question. 36. Kuber Limited furnishes with you the following draft balance sheet as on 31st March 2012. Some balance sheet is given to us and come down below. The company redeems preference shares on 1st April 2012. It also bought back 50 lakh equity shares of 10 rupees each at 50 rupees per share. The payments for the above were made out of huge bank balances forming part of your current assets. He's asking you to pass the journal entries, prepare the balance sheet, and value the net asset, value equity share on net assets basis. So let's start with the journal entries then. Journal entries in the books of Kuber Limited. The company redeems the preference share capital first. Check the capital in the books. Balance sheet, preference share capital is 12%. Preference share capital account debit 75. They're redeemed at premium, sorry, at par only, transfer it to preference shareholders. Settle the preference shareholders. Preference shareholders account debit to bank. I'll create CRR later, guys. Don't ignore. It also bought back 50 lakh equity shares. Check the first entry. Buyback of shares account debit. To bank. Calculate 50 lakh shares each of 50 rupees. I'm writing everything in crores. So this becomes 25. Next one, cancellation of shares bought back, equity share capital, 50 lakh shares into 10 rupees each, 5 crores, balance amount should be premium on buyback, ₹50 is the buyback price, ₹40 is the premium, so 40 into 50 lakh is 20 crores. To buyback of shares 25. Premium on buyback should be cancelled against securities premium available. Do I have sufficient securities premium? Yes. So securities premium account debit 20. To premium on buyback. 20. CRR creation, what is the total reduction in the share capital? Preference shares reduced by 75. Equity share capital reduced by 5. Total reduction is 80. For that 80, you can use any reserve, free reserve that you have as a P&L surplus. P&L to CRR 75. Preference share, 5 equity share, so CRR is 80. Subsequently prepare the balance sheet. No preferential capital, redeemed it is, so preferential equity share capital is also 20 only. 5 is already bought back. Reserves and surplus. Most rigid reserve CRR, first reserve 80. Securities premium, what was existing in the balance sheet was 25, but I used it to the extent of 20, balance remaining is 5. I did not touch the capital reserve by any chance. 15, surplus, that is nothing but the P&L, I used 80, balance available is 180. No non-current liabilities, only current liabilities, 40. non-current assets. Tangible fixed assets, after depreciation, nil. No intangible assets, I have investments, other non-current assets, cost being 100, market value is 400. Current assets, pehle 340, I paid to equity shareholder 75, I paid to preference shareholder 75, equity shareholders 25. Balance is 240. This total is 340. Last part of the question, value equity share on net assets basis. My net assets value per share. Before and after, let's try to compare. How do we get net assets? Assets minus outside liabilities. Come on, go with the assets. First one, fixed assets does not have a value, I'm not taking it, but investments have a market value. Always take it realizable values, 400. Current asset, before it was 340, after in the balance sheet what we prepared just now, 240. Total assets are 740 and 640. Reduced by the outside liability. Outside liabilities are only current liabilities, that's it. This will give me net assets 700 and 600. Less preference share capital. Before there was preference share capital of 75, after there is nothing. That will give us net assets attributable to equity shareholders. 625 and 600 divided by the number of equity shares before the number of equity shares was 2.5. Now the equity share is only 2. Before buyback we had 2.5 crore shares, now I have only 2 crore shares. Net asset value per share 250 and 300. Obviously there will be an increase in the value, guys. Simple logical reason is, if the value per share before is 250, how much did he acquire for? He is buying it for 50 rupees. Obviously the remaining share should increase in value. That's all he has, value per share. Yes guys, turn to the next one, problem 37. Summarize balance sheet of Gunshot Limited as on 31st March 2012 is given. And he says, Gunshot bought back 16,000 shares of 20 rupees each. For this purpose, the company sold all the non-trade investments for 3,20,000. Give the journal entries with full narrations affecting the buyback. Buyback entries 3, 1 sale of non-trade investments, 1 entry, that's it. 4 entries and you are through. Did not even ask you the balance sheet, guys. Only the journal entries. Journal entries in the books of Gunshot. First entry should be for the sale of investments. Investments having a book value of 3 lakhs were sold for 3,20,000. I'll write everything in thousands only. Balance sheet figures are given in thousands. First, bank account debit. $320 to non-trade investments, $300, profit of $20, P&L. Second one, for this purpose they have buyback of 16,000 shares. Buyback of shares account debit to bank. How many shares? 16,000 shares. So I'll write it as 16 into 20 because everything is written in thousands. So this will become 320. I have to cancel these shares bought back equity share capital account debit, 16,000 shares into 10, 160. Premium on buyback, because you are buying back at 20 when the face value of each share is 10, so your premium is also 10. To buyback of shares, 320. This premium on buyback should be cancelled against securities premium. Do I have? Yes, I have sufficient securities premium. No. So not sufficient enough, the securities premium given there, because securities premium is only 100. So the balance, you can pick it up from general reserve, it has 780. You can pick it up from there. Securities premium account debit, 100. General reserve account debit, 60. To premium on buyback, 160. We cancel this premium on buyback. Now last final, we have to create CRR. Yes guys, create CRR. CRR to the extent of share reduction in share capital, 160. I'll use general reserve, sufficient it is. General reserve to CRR.